Hello, my name is Amelia Bradshaw, and I am the ArcGIS Pro Product Advocacy Lead at Esri. Today, I will take you through a tour of the top 10 items that were added to ArcGIS Pro 3.1. I hope you are excited to explore these new features. Let's get started. In ArcGIS Pro 3.1, we have included both improvements to the software and new functionality that should be helpful in your work. These include new data types, a new extension for drone and aerial imagery processing, improvements to layouts, symbology, labels, and scenes, and ArcMap equivalency items, including a popular request from our users. Interested to see what these features are? Here, let me show you. Use catalog layers to organize, explore, and visualize geographic datasets from multiple workspaces together. These polygons are footprints of the dataset items referenced in this catalog layer. The Layers and View node lists the visible layers, which are based on the extent, definition query, and time and range filters of the map. You can control the number of layers and their drawing order. To do analysis or make a map, you can create a separate layer. The source of a catalog layer is a catalog dataset. Use geoprocessing to create a catalog dataset and crawl through workspaces or a portal to add references to items, services, and datasets. Now, when you change the size of a layout, you can check resize elements to have all the layout elements grow or shrink in proportion to the page size. Resize elements is also available when you change the page orientation. Finally, the duplicate layout button allows you to make a copy of the layout with a new name and a different size, again with the option to resize elements. ArcGIS Pro now supports time-enabled scene layers. You can create point or 3D object scene layer packages or web scene layers that are time-enabled when the input data has date fields. You can adjust the time zone information in the new time zone environment. Additionally, you can time-enable scene layer packages created in earlier versions using the Upgrade Scene Layer tool. Once you have a time-enabled scene layer, you can enable time on the time page of the layer properties. Use the time slider to visualize data in certain time spans. In this example, we are viewing building construction dates over a 75-year time span. Scale-based label sizing is now supported at ArcGIS Pro 3.1. With this addition, you can specify text symbol size ranges to be used between map scales. This sizing will help to reduce visual density at smaller scales while retaining an appropriate relative size at larger scales. The Magnifier tool is available in Maps and can be activated with a right click in the Map view or from the View tab in the ribbon. Magnifier zoom level can be set by percent or by scale. And the position can be changed by dragging the window or by panning within it. The window can also be pinned to a specific spot to make navigating and viewing the map easier. Within the magnifier window, you can also open pop-ups, edit features, and make measurements. Whether you need a full-resolution digital surface model, distortion-free true ortho imagery, high-density point cloud, or a digital twin of your project area, ArcGIS Reality for ArcGIS Pro provides you with the tools you need to extract from imagery the data you require to support your organization's projects. With ArcGIS Pro 3.1, the parcel fabric can be used to manage vertical parcels. We copied lines from a DWG CAD file to define the second floor in a condominium building. By setting the floor order field to 2, the build process can associate lines and parcel seeds to the correct floor. Since the floor plan repeats for floors 2 to 6, we can use the enhanced duplicate command to duplicate the floor plan 4 more times while updating the floor order field. The results can be viewed in the 3D scene view. The hotspot analysis comparison tool compares two hotspot results for their similarity and statistical dependence. You can compare different variables, such as hotspots of tree coverage and hotspots of precipitation. And you can also compare the same variable at different times, such as comparing hotspots of health indicators in 2016 to those in 2019. Overall global comparisons are returned as geoprocessing messages, and local results are returned in a group layer that emphasizes areas where the two results are most different. You can now specify the drawing order of features based on their attributes. Here, a date time field is used to draw older earthquakes above more recent ones. You can combine attributes to refine the feature drawing order further. Part-to-whole relationships can now be visualized using pie charts. Pie charts can be created by selecting multiple numeric fields, where each field represents a slice in the pie, or by selecting a category field where each unique value is represented by a slice in the pie. For a clearer visualization, small slices can be grouped by setting a percent threshold, and the chart can be viewed as a donut instead by using the shape slider. That wraps up our top 10 new features in ArcGIS Pro 3.1. For a full list of everything new in this release, please head over to the What's New documentation for ArcGIS Pro. Thank you for watching. I look forward to speaking to you all soon.